In this demonstration, we will use the Self-Check Worksheet for study data preparation for an NDA application with clinical study data. This will help us determine if the files and information we are planning to submit are sufficient and meet study data standards. We begin in section one by entering the application and submission information. So we select CDER for our FDA center to which we're submitting. Our application type is NDA. And for our purposes, we'll put 123456 for our application number in this example, and our ECTD sequence number is 1. In section 2, we enter general information about the study. Our study ID is XYZ-123. And we confirm that this is the first time that we're submitting information for this study. And we're submitting a PK study. So for the title of this study, we'll simply put PK study. Our ECTD section is 5332. And of course, we're submitting a clinical study in module 5 in 5332. And our data set types are actually, we're planning to submit tabulation and analysis data. We have SDTM data sets and also ADAM data sets. In section 3, we enter information about the study tagging file. Section 5332 is a study section, so we are submitting files in a study section. And we have prepared an STF file for our study, and we've made sure that STF does reference all of the files that we're planning to submit as part of this study. Then we confirm our study ID again, XYZ-123, to confirm that it matches what we previously entered for our study ID. And we do plan to submit XPT datasets with our study. XPT datasets are among the files that we're submitting. And 3G is not applicable because we're submitting clinical study data. Section 4 focuses on trial summary requirements. Our study started July 1st, 2019, after December 17th, 2016. The table will help determine the requirements for a TS file. It's a clinical study with an NDA application to CDER. So we know that a full trial summary data set is required. Yes, a TS file is required, and yes, we have prepared a full trial summary data set. So a section appears to enter details for our trial summary data set. We confirm that the study ID in our TS file matches the study ID in our SDF file. If our study ID does not match, we could use SPREF ID in the TS file to provide a matching study ID as an alternative. As we said, our study start date is July 1st, 2019. And we double check that we've provided the study start date in the TS file in the correct format. So now we've completed section 4, and confirmed that our study would pass validation rule 1734. In section 5, we focus on requirements for standardized data. So we confirm that yes, standardized data is required based on the table. And then we provide information for our clinical study data. So we confirm that the required files are included and that the file tags for those files are correct. So we are including a DM file and also an associated defined file for a tabulation data. We also confirm that the file tags for the SDTM datasets is data tabulation dataset SDTM in our STF, and that our defined file is tagged data tabulation data definition. For our ADAM datasets, we are providing an ADSL, and we're also providing a defined XML for our ADAM dataset. So we confirm that the file tags for the datasets and the associated defined file are correct. So analysis dataset ADAM for our datasets and analysis data definition for our defined XML. So that brings us to the end of the self-check worksheet. So therefore, we confirm that we meet the requirements for validation rules 1735 and 1736, and that we won't violate any of the technical rejection criteria for study data rules.